All I can say is sham. Wow.
Hi, it's Vince with ShamWow. You'll be saying wow every time you use this towel. Oh my gosh, I don't even buy paper towels anymore. Are you following me, camera guy? Are you following me, camera guy?
All I can say is sham.
Wow.
Sham wow, you'll be saying wow every time.
I can't live without it. I just love it.
Are you following me, camera guy? Are you following me, camera guy?
This is the ShamWow story and documentary in my eyes. The true story in my eyes. Over the years, commercials have dominated the televisions that we watch. But until now, we've never seen nothing quite as powerful as the infomercial. They last 30 minutes, up to an hour even at times. Business giants make these to make us think we need the things they sell because we need the things they want because they want us to think we need them to survive. Yeah, they get more outrageous every time there's a new one. Even the salespeople, check this chick out. And then one day the infomercial headquarters giants remembered an old commercial, which reminded them of a product that they had stored in the back room. It was like a paper towel, but not quite. It was a little better, not quite a paper towel, so they put their head executives in charge of finding a salesman to sell it. This guy had to be someone the ladies would love, that kids would like, to sell these not quite paper towel thingies that were soft as a kitten. Oh, and the guy had to have a really cool eyebrow trick. But since nobody like that existed, they had to create a person. By infusing a donated egg with the specially designed salesman gene and implanting in the first couple they could find to carry the new salesman baby. 9 months later, baby Vince would be born. Vince is an innocent name, but it really stands for Vocal Interactive Nostalgic Commercial Expert.
Did you spill your milk?
And from the minute Vince could use a paper towel, they forced him to use single-ply generic paper towels to clean up every mess that was planted in the house. The paper towels would fall apart, leaving his hand wet. It was disgusting and a nightmare for Vince. But this would be training to help him appreciate the product he would sell the public, making him even that much better of a salesman. Throughout his adolescence, they honed in on his salesman skills by selling cookies to old ladies. Their work was finally done, they thought. But then, 10 years later, at the age of 18, Vince would choose a different path than the one they had designed. He wanted to be a gangster rapper. But that kind of fell through, so Vince turned to the wrong crowd for help. The really wrong crowd. He seeked answers from the bottle, until divine intervention would come in the form of police one day, arrest all the bad people surrounding Vince, and the infomercial headquarters implanted this guy in his life, who kind of looked like Ashton Kutcher and the guy from Buffy the Vampire Slayer. They would become best friends. The guy hooked Vince up with the Shopping Channel for an interview for the new not quite paper towel type thingies that they had in the closet. Vince poured his heart and soul out into the audition. He got the job. First it was small at flea markets, so he did other movies on the side. Not quite so flattering movies, that is. The roles were kind of strange, but they helped pay the bills, I guess. And then Vince got the call. He was the new ShamWow spokesman for the television. Infomercial, that is. Vince was on TVs all across America. He was on TV Guide and magazines, even in people's dreams as they slept at night. Vince was the man. That's right, the man. He made so many friends we had to speed up this entire video just to show you a few. Most of them were hotties. Some of them weren't. But most of them were, really. He even made friends with a guy from My Name is Earl, Crabman. Now, don't get much cooler than that. Over time, all the fame would kind of get to Vince, and he would kind of snap. Yeah, he kind of lost it. He thought back about his friend that looked like Ashton Kutcher, kind of, and the Buffy guy, and decided, you know, Ashton Kutcher, he's who's to blame for my insanity. He has to pay. So he decided he would steal his girlfriend, Demi Moore, But to do that, he had to get Ashton out of the way. So he kidnapped him. And in Vince's new demented mind, he would torture Ashton far worse than we could ever think of torturing people at Guantanamo Bay. He forced him to listen for hours repeatedly to the Soggy Bottom Boys. That's right, the Soggy Bottom Boys. But Ashton stayed pretty strong through that, which pissed Vince off, so he took it up a notch. And he rickrolled him repeatedly throughout the night. I'd say probably at least 12 good rickrolls. And when Ashton was finally wore out, Vince made his move. Decided now is the time that Ashton Kutcher has to die. So he killed him. Cleaned up the blood with a super absorbent ShamWow. Ashton's out of the way, he could have Demi Moore. But he forgot one thing. Bruce Willis. But Vince was a nut. He didn't care. He's like, bring it on, Brucey. And this pissed off Brucey really bad. So nobody really knows what happened to Vince, but we're pretty sure he's dead somewhere. This left an opening in the ShamWow sales department. They couldn't find quite the right person to fill it. Nobody could fill Vince's shoes. ShamWows were stocking up on the shelves while ShamWow imitators were taking over until divine intervention would come in the form of Billy Mays.
Billy Mays here, breaking your back, pounding, super strong, super, super strong. Now that's the strength of Billy Mays guaranteed. Super strong, super, super strong.
Nobody could sell anything quite as good as Billy Mays. They had to change the name from ShamWow to another product that I really don't remember the name, but even Billy couldn't go without pissing the wrong person off. And that's the end of Billy Mays now. ShamWow has killed Billy Mays, Ashton Kutcher, and Vince. But good for you, because they're now hiring a new spokesman. You can apply at www.shamwow.com. Thanks for watching.